To those of you who are here in church, and to those of you watching online, good morning. This is the third weekend that Jesus is instructing the 12 disciples in what to do in ministry when Jesus sends them out to preach the kingdom of heaven. We are asked by Jesus today to take up our crosses in his life in order to be worthy of Jesus. We always put our trust in God. Today, there will be a collection for Peter's Pence. The Peter's Pence collection is a gesture of solidarity through which every member of the faithful can participate in the activity of the Pope as pastor of the Universal Church. Put your donation in the envelopes provided in the pews and place the envelope in the regular collection basket. Thank you for supporting the ministry of Pope Francis. Please remember to silence your cell phones so that we can worship God without distraction. Thank you. Our celebrant for this Mass is Father Peter, and our preacher for today is Father Francis.
Let us begin our Mass by singing as found on the two boards in the front, number 715, Take Up Your Cross. The G is the Gloria that we'll sing today, but let us begin with 715.
Take up your cross, take up your cross, take up your cross and follow me. Take up your cross, take up your cross, take up your cross and follow me. Whoever wishes to come after me must deny himself. take up your cross, take up your cross and follow me.
In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Today in the gospel, we're going to hear how God calls us to put his son Jesus ahead of everything else in our lives. And Father Francis is going to explain what that means and how we can do that. So as we enter into our liturgy, let us call to mind the times that we have perhaps fallen off of his path and ask for his grace and strength to come back on his path and follow our journey toward him. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Peace on earth.
let us pray. O God, who through the grace of adoption chose us to be children of light, grant, we pray, that we may not be wrapped in the darkness of error, but always be seen to stand in the bright light of truth. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the second book of Kings. One day, Elisha came to Shunem, where there was a woman of influence who urged him to dine with her. Afterward, whenever he passed by, he used to stop there to dine. So she said to her husband, "I know that Elisha is a holy man of God. Since he visits us often, let us arrange a little room on the roof and furnish it for him with a bed, table, chair, and lamp, so that when he comes to us, he can stay there." Sometime later, Elisha arrived and stayed in the room overnight. Later, Elisha asked, "Can something be done for her?" His servant Gehazi answered, "Yes. She has no son, and her husband is getting on in years." Elisha said, "Call her." When the woman had been called and stood at the door, Elisha promised, "This time next year, you will be fondling a baby son." The word of the Lord.
Shield, he is the Holy One of Israel, our King.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, are you unaware that we who were baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death? We were indeed buried with him through baptism into death, so that just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might live in newness of life. If then we have died with Christ, we believe that we shall also live with him. We know that Christ, raised from the dead, dies no more. Death no longer has power over him. As to his death, he died to sin once and for all. As to his life, he lives for God. Consequently, you too must think of yourselves as dead to sin and living for God in Christ Jesus. The word of the Lord.
With you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus said to his apostles, "Whoever loves father or mother more than me is not worthy of me. And whoever loves son or daughter more than me is not worthy of me. And whoever does not take up his cross and follow after me is not worthy of me. Whoever finds his life will lose it, and whoever loses his life for my sake will find it. Whoever receives you receives me, and whoever receives me receives the one who sent me. Whoever receives a prophet because he is a prophet will receive a prophet's reward. And whoever receives a righteous man because he is a righteous man will receive a righteous man's reward. And whoever gives only a cup of cold water to one of these little ones to drink because the little one is a disciple, amen, I say to you, he will surely not lose his reward." Beloved brothers and sisters, the Holy Gospel of the Lord. Praise you, Lord Jesus Christ. Well, today is the second day of July. We're in the month of July now. Day after tomorrow is the 4th of July. So this is a different stage of the summer. Now we're serious and we're getting into our summer season. And we hear a gospel today that really challenges us. Jesus demands that God be first in our lives. Jesus says, "If there is anything or anyone more important to you in this life than me, then you are not worthy of me." Oh, no. This is really hard. If you don't go all the way with me in this business of shepherding and bringing the kingdom of God into the world, if you don't go with me all the way, then you don't deserve me. Well, this is very hard. How can we possibly be worthy of God? Well, we can't, but God makes it so. That's why we started the Mass with Lord have mercy. It starts with asking God for his help. It shakes me up to hear this gospel. I really wish somebody else was preaching this weekend. But it shakes me up, and it shakes us up to hear this because there are many things and people who compete for first place in our lives. First place in my life, and maybe in yours as well, can be a crowded place where things compete with each other, and urgency makes them all the more intense. So I think we need to listen more carefully to Jesus and to listen to his teaching. We may reach an understanding with him and maybe an understanding of ourselves. 2 weeks ago, Father Isaiah Mary, he challenged us, and he said that we have been named and chosen to follow Jesus and to share in his work. Listen to the order of things. We have been named and chosen. By whom? Well, God. God named and chose us to follow after Jesus. Any desire that we have to love God and to be close to God, that comes from God. That doesn't come from us. It is God's initiative, a grace that we didn't deserve, but that is already at work in us. And last Sunday, Father Peter preached to us of what it means to be named and chosen. He clarified that it means to be Jesus' disciple and to proclaim his name in the world. So this Sunday is the third Sunday in a row that builds on Jesus' teaching of how to be a disciple. Jesus clearly demands of us our whole life and all activities, all things and the people in our lives and our future, our plans as well. So we are told to come to Jesus with all of these and to give them to him. We can also give to Jesus our past, our memories, our sins and our failures, the times we have acted out of a broken human nature. All of these things too, we can put into his hands. All of those places we have been of darkness, we put them in God's hands. God wants those too, because he fills things with life and he makes them holy. He does that to us. So give all of this to God. Today's gospel proclaims whoever loves parents, children, and home more than me is not worthy of me. Why would Jesus say that? The most intense relationships in our lives, for good or for bad, are our family. That's what makes us who we are. God gave us our family. And God, I've never forgiven you for that. That's why I'm like this. Our family, for good or for bad, those are intense relationships. And if you're a parent, you love your children ferociously. You love them intensely. And of course, they are first in your life. Jesus says, whoever does not take up his cross and follow me is not worthy of me. And that this is the basic condition to be a disciple. But how is it that Jesus can claim that first place in my life like this? When my first concerns are children and spouse, parents, also in things like job, finances, health, safety, dozens, even hundreds of things compete to be the most important thing. And we sacrifice ourselves day after day for the people in our lives. We spend ourselves pouring out our limited resources into the many people and the projects and activities of our life. But if we're expecting that all of these demands and these demanding relationships are to make us look good, then we will neither find God nor will we find ourselves. God has given us these things, the very people and relationships that fill our lives, and we are not to think that we can manage and provide for everyone without His help. To grow closer to God, the very first step, the very first step of discipleship is surrender. A lovely prayer about surrender, a prayer when we're overwhelmed, is to pray, "O Jesus, I surrender myself to you. Take care of everything." Now, if you are a person who is in control of everything in your life and you hang on to it, you're going to probably want to run as far away from this prayer as you can possibly get. But if you're like most of us, you understand what it is to be overwhelmed, and overwhelmed many times. And a really good way to surrender to God each day is to say, "I offer this day to you, dear God. I offer to you my thoughts. I offer to you my words. I offer to you all my actions this day, Lord. And bless the people who I meet today. May they think that I'm better than I am, but may I serve them, may I love them. Oh, Jesus, I surrender myself to you. Take care of everything. Take care of my fears. Take care of my concerns and my plans and anything that can happen to harm anybody. Take care of everything and make us safe." To grow closer to God is to pray that way and to understand who Jesus is. Jesus, through you, all things come into being. You are the eternal Word incarnate of the Father. You have come from the Father and taken on our human flesh and our whole human nature except in sin, and you give yourself to us. This is the way that we are to understand our Savior, who has poured out Himself for us, and we therefore pour ourselves back to Him, and we give ourselves back to Him, entrusting ourselves to Him. A beautiful hymn in yesterday's book of the morning prayer Lauds, there's a hymn that said, "You are the sweetness of all hearts." Imagine that. You are the sweetness of all hearts. You are the fountain of truth, the light of minds. You go beyond all other joy, beyond all earthly longing or desire. A very famous saint we talk about a lot, Saint Augustine, he hesitated a long time in his life to surrender to God. But when he did, it changed the church. He was such a powerful writer and preacher and teacher. He wrote, "My heart is restless, O God, until I rest in you." He wrote,
God, you have made me for yourself. These beautiful ways of understanding how God calls us because he loves us. So finally, we are to be intimately connected to Jesus as his disciples. So in the gospel today, after he's talked about the condition of unless you put everything else secondary to me, and then we have done that, he says, whoever receives you receives me, and whoever receives me receives the one who sent me. But this is a very different kind of speaking all of a sudden. Jesus has changed the tone of this exhortation. Whoever receives a righteous man because he is a righteous man will receive a righteous man's reward. And whoever receives a prophet because he is a prophet will receive a prophet's reward. Where we are all to be these things, the righteous person, a prophet. And Jesus tells us how to begin. And it's so simple. It's so small. It's so tiny what he suggests to us. And he says, whoever gives only a cup of cold water to one of these little ones because he is a disciple of mine, amen, I say, you will surely not lose his reward. So why not? This way of bringing the kingdom of heaven into the world is what God has called us to do. So we ask him to be in control because he's the source of all life and goodness. And the important work that we are to do comes from such a effortless place in us. You don't have to work hard to get it because you already have it. It's your gifts and your talents, the things that you can't help but do. Those are the things that fill up the need in the church and bringing what no other person can do. And if it starts with this little cup of water, why not do that? Give a refreshing cup of water to someone who is thirsty. Jesus said it, and I think that's manageable. And then how about this? Stop and give a kind word to someone. Or have a kind talk with someone you already know and tell them that even if the whole world doesn't care, that you care. Tell them, I care. Because only God knows the next step, what it will be, and where this can lead.
Let us now profess our faith in the God who calls us to put him ahead of all in our lives. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. God loves us and waits for us to ask for what we need. Let us now present to the Lord our needs and petitions.
For all the Catholic faithful, that we die to sin and live for God in Christ Jesus, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all our government leaders in the United States, and especially here in California, that they respect freedom of religions in all their votes, decisions, and speeches, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our nation, as we prepare to celebrate Independence Day, that we be thankful for all who have given service to keep our country free. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the healing of Angelus de Guzman, who we remember in a special way at this Mass, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the intentions written in our book of prayer, and for all the intentions we hold in the silence of our hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. God, you are spirit and truth. Hear the prayers we offer with hearts supported by your constant love. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Praise unending. Now, my friends, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice
of your Son. O God, who graciously accomplished the effects of your mysteries, grant, we pray, that the deeds by which we serve you may be worthy of these sacred gifts through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father most holy, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your Word, through whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin, fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people. He stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so with the angels and all the saints, we declare your glory as with one voice we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Dominic and all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis our Pope, Jose our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that, by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer to each other the sign of peace. Receiving communion today, or those joining us live stream, we pray. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Let us pray. May this divine sacrifice we have offered and received fill us with life, O Lord, we pray, so that bound to you in lasting charity, we may bear fruit that lasts forever through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated a moment for some announcements. Tomorrow, Monday, July 3rd, our office and facilities will be open. Monday's not a national holiday, so we'll have our regular schedule of daily masses at 8 a.m. and 6 p.m. And on Tuesday, July 4th, we're closed. And we'll have one mass at 9 a.m. And please join us to celebrate the wonderful gifts and blessings we have in our country. And please see the bulletin for details on these events. But our Girl Scout project is still going along for the North Central Animal Shelter. And in the bulletin, there's a list of items that they need for the animals in the shelter, and you can bring them in to a box in the parish office. And our parish will be having two guest priests, Franciscans from the Renewal from New Mexico. And they are going to give presentations on the Eucharistic revival. And there'll be three presentations: the healing power of the Eucharist, the Eucharistic pledge of future glory, and become Eucharistified. Now, when I put that in Microsoft Word, it came up misspelled. And I don't know how to fix it. So you got to come to figure out what Eucharistified means. This is going to be in about a week and a half, a week from Wednesday. It'll be Wednesday, July 12th at 7 p.m. So this is a wonderful way to hear how the Eucharist really should be important in our lives and what it does for our lives. And the Legion of Mary at St. Dominic's will celebrate its 40th year of ministry here at St. Dominic's. It's a huge ministry. No church in Los Angeles has more presidia or groups of the Legion of Mary than we have at St. Dominic's. So we're going to celebrate this on Saturday, July 15th, 2 weeks from yesterday, at 10 a.m. with presentations and prayers and lunch. And we're going to have two of the leaders of the Legion of Mary in Ireland flying out here to give some of the presentations. So don't miss it. And again, there's information in the bulletin. So take the bulletin home today. And then read it. Thank you. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you all, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us go forth to glorify the Lord by our lives.
Thanks be to God.
Spacious night.